Yeah, but I'm just thinking too.
Well, not that exact there, though.
What do you got, Chuck?
I don't know. He's coming through his desk.
What do you mean the same thing happened on both of them?
No. Something different, but there's no power there.
And it says, yeah, there's a servo.
The drive is not on?
It says
yeah, it's still not
coming. You've got to be overlooking. He's got to be overlooking something, Chuck.
Yeah, I know.
This one says load parts. This one, hey, Chuck. Is that it?
That's it.
So what do you have to...
What happens is...
Explain that to Rich, if you don't mind.
Rich.
This one right here. On this bracket right here. You know all the map hole.
Actually, I didn't map hole.
No, that's what I didn't hear. You did this thing down here.
Chuck, hang on. I'm gonna...
Everybody here.
Yeah.
All right, go ahead, do it.
All right, hang on. I'm going to try something else. I'm going to do it the same way we've been doing it. Now they all should be off, right? There should be no power.
You have to shut main power. You have to turn the thing on the box over there.
Well, hang on a minute. I'm gonna.
The disconnect.
Bring it back up.
The disconnect on the power box.
Try the disconnect on the power box.
Well, hang on a minute.
That's the only way to really reset it, is to disconnect the power box.
Well, I know.
This shuts off control power.
What?
I pulled the wires up here, remember?
Oh, hang on. You want me to kill? I'm not in contact.
If he screams, you know.
Nothing there should be affected by that. I'm going to try killing the... I'm going to do an e-stop.
I'm glad there's a lot of water over there, though. The controller is getting there.
Yeah, you said you got an FO1?
Yeah.
And you try to do it at home?
You can move it. You can get power. Yeah, I think they have the money to do it.
Yeah, but this one...
There's no power to it, so...
You haven't got power to it.
So we want the wire to run through.
So why is going to... You see this button right here, the pick and play, the manual cycle? It's going to go...
Okay, what do you want me to do?
I'm going to go just until they reach the top, and then you can stop loading them in. I'm going to film from the top. You can stop once they reach the top. It's an auto, right? It's an auto, right?
Yeah.
It'll keep indexing up?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm going to try for a moment.
Yeah, all right. Once they all transfer, I'm going to stop it because we're already almost at 5 minutes and it's getting big.
Okay, here goes.
How many you gave me? About 50?
Probably.
That picture? Oh, sorry guys.
It's almost 10 minutes. I'm gonna stop this at 10 minutes. Because I know 20 minutes is 600 megs. So this will be 300. How do you separate that video?
It does it automatically.
Oh, the zip does?
Yeah.
Oh, alright. But you know what? You can't even email a 10 meg file. You know, I'm downloading it to a photo bucket, and that takes 500 meg. But to do that took me like 45 minutes, and at the end it said error. So then I downloaded software to edit the video. That took me a while. I edit the video. I have to learn how to edit the video. I get it down to like 400. I wait for like 15, 20 more minutes to download it, and it says error. All right, 35 more seconds, and then I'm going to... That was a full cycle of boards from in to out. There's no more double shelf movement. The new sensors seem to work very well. The program was modified to ensure that this cannot happen. I'm shutting down the video because it's 10 minutes. Thank you very much.